What's it about?
What's it about? What do you think it's about? So we're not mic'd up. We're on the camera mic, so I have to speak loudly, okay?
It's not going to go well.
It is. Okay, welcome to your weekly Kubernetes moment. I'm Nigel Poulton, and
I'm Lily Poulton.
You need to be louder.
Sorry.
Go again with that.
I'm Lily Poulton.
Okay, so Lily, we've got a board over there that tells us what's going on in the Kubernetes world this month. Do you want to tell us what's on the board?
1.16.
Okay, so Kubernetes 1.16, we call it 1.16, that's cool though, right? So Kubernetes 1.16 landed like last week, and the three things that I've picked as the highlights for Kubernetes 1.16 are on the board. So what are those three things, Lil?
CRDs, volumes, and cheese slices.
Cheese slices. Okay, we'll come to that one. So CRDs got a major bump in Kubernetes 1.16. I think they've been alpha since like, I should have checked this. Well, I did earlier. It's about like 1.6 or 1.7. They've now been promoted to stable. Volumes gets a bunch of cool stuff. And we'll probably talk about all this in the future. But I want to talk about cheese slices, right? Hang on.
Plastic cheese.
Props. All right. Plastic cheese. Well, it's cheese in individual plastic slices. That's not good for the environment, we know that. And the block of halloumi cheese, right? So, why are we talking about cheese? Kubernetes 1.16 doesn't really have anything to do with cheese slices, but it has a really cool new feature called endpoint slices. Right, so a Kubernetes endpoint stores all of the pods that match a particular service, right? And when we start to scale things, so if we've got a large Kubernetes cluster with a lot of pods and a lot of things going on, and especially a lot of change, the endpoints object that's associated with a service can get really big, right? So we're going to assume this block of
Halloumi,
thanks, is your endpoints object, okay? And let's say it's got 10,000 pods that match. I'm picking a big number, right? Okay, so there's your endpoints object. Every time you make a change to your cluster that changes anything within that endpoints object, okay, that entire endpoints object changes and has to be shipped across the network to every node and every kubelet running in your cluster, right? So it's got 10,000 pods match. We change one pod, let's say it dies, or we add a new pod, or holy cow, imagine like a rolling update where tons of them are changing, okay? But take the example of where just one changes. You have to resend the entire block of halloumi cheese, so the entire endpoints object, across the network to every node. So we've only changed one pod in there, right? But every node and the network has to consume the entire endpoints object again. So how hard would it be, Lil, to eat that entire block of cheese? Do you like cheese?
No.
Okay, all right. What do you like? What's something that you like? Chocolate. Okay, if that was a block of chocolate, right? It's quite a lot to eat, yeah? Pretty thick, okay? Well, so that's your endpoints object, okay? Change one pod, the whole thing changes, the whole thing gets shipped across the network. Every kubelet on every node has to consume the entire thing again, right? When it's big, it's a lot to consume. Enter cheese slices, or endpoints slices, right? So what endpoint slices does is it kind of takes an endpoints object, right? And it slices it up. Cool wheel, right? Slices it up, and at the moment, every endpoint slice contains 100 endpoints, okay? So we've got 1, 2, 3, four, five. So let's pretend it was 1,000, right? We've got 5,000 endpoints there, right? We change one of them. It's not on that slice. Oh, that's loud. It's not on that slice. It's not on that slice. It's not on that slice. It is on that slice. This is the only slice that you have to throw across the network and that has to be consumed, eat it, by every node and every kubelet in the cluster, right? Anyway, that's the principle, right? So if you have a small Kubernetes cluster, it doesn't really make a difference, okay? But when you start getting to scale and you have large endpoints objects and lots of them and lots of churn in your cluster, lots of little changes, okay? Well, with endpoints objects, you are recutting the entire object, sending the whole thing across the cluster all the time. With endpoint slices, okay, you only send the slice that's got the change, much easier to eat. As of the 25th of September 2019, endpoint slices in Kubernetes 1.16 are an alpha feature, okay? Do you know what that means, an alpha feature?
Wait, like first?
First? Bingo, right? What I always say, though, is, first of all, anything that's in alpha has to be specifically enabled on your cluster, okay? So we're getting this to you quite early, okay? But also means it's a little bit hairy and scary. It might be subject to change before it's promoted to stable or generally available. I've no idea, right? 2, 3, 4 versions time, all right? But that's endpoint slices. That's your Kubernetes moment. I'm Nigel Poulton.
I'm Lily Poulton.
Remember to what? What do they have to do? What do all YouTubers ask people to do? You want to be a YouTuber, right?
My turn.
Talk to the camera. What do you do?
Subscribe.
Well, tell the camera.
Subscribe.
Subscribe to the channel, yeah? You're going to tell us about Kubernetes now, Lil. How much do you know about it?
That it's what you do. And it is a wheel.
And it's a wheel.
That's the symbol.
How old are you?
13.
13, right. My oldest daughter, 13. I live and breathe Kubernetes every day, and that is the best that you can do?
That they have cheese slices.
Mandatory reading. Take it home. See you later. Got to say, right, if you go into KubeCon, or if you can, you should, but if you are going to KubeCon in San Diego this November, then sign up for my workshop. If you like it, or if you like my content, or if you want to connect with me, I promise you will love the workshop. So it's on Monday the 18th, the day before the official conference starts. They call it a 0-day event, but I've got a room booked. I'm running a couple of Kubernetes 101 courses. We'll learn all about how Kubernetes works. We'll deploy an app, we'll scale it, self-heal it, rolling updates, rollbacks, probably health checks, all that kind of goodness, right? If you like my content, if you want to connect, sign up for the workshop. See you at KubeCon, yeah? Magic.